Hello, anybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Rogue Legacy. I'm Mr. Debius, or just D, but in the last episode, we had a character who was too big to even fit in a portrait. And in today's episode, we are hopefully going to go down and actually deal with Herodotus in this episode, once and for all in this episode. But we're just going to have to see how it goes. This character has Alzheimer's. We're not going to play the character with Alzheimer's because you don't get a map with them. That's really bad. You can still warp around, but you can't really see the map so well. And I think I'm going to cycle these characters to try and get a class that we haven't played in a little while. So let's play as the Paladin, who can throw knives out their butt and they're huge. They're huge. I played a huge character before. Surely it won't go badly this time. By which I mean it's going to go badly this time too. Just you wait and see. Okay, let's see what equipment we can get really quick. The Sky Sword will do more damage for us, and it actually weighs less than the Guardian Sword. Although it doesn't give us any armor unlike that sword did, but who cares? And we are going to put on this new cape. So now we have finished up the Sky set, and we can start build. I know we didn't even really finish up the Guardian set, but now we can start on like the Imperial limbs, and that's going to be fun when the time comes. In fact, we could do that right now, but I want to keep my armor consistent, so I'm just going to, for at least one episode, so I'm going to keep this on. And we're going to just increase our chance for a critical. I should have done Death Defy, I know, but I'm also going to increase our armor. And before heading to the castle, I will be right back. Okay, and we are back. It's time to head in with this armor set that I actually like a lot, and just question marks floating out of our head. That's lovely. Just lovely. Oh, it's been a while since we've played the Paladin. I think maxed out, the Paladin probably ends up being like the best character in the game. At least, that's the thought I've heard from Birder, and I can see that definitely being the case. Today's definitely going to be the last episode I record for today, because this is the fifth one I'm on now. Yeah, think about recording is usually you only got a couple episodes in you, but with a game like Rogue Legacy, it's hard to put down. Very hard to put down, because it very much has the feeling of just one more. Just one more. That's just how it feels. Let's not get careless, though, just because, you know, we have high stats, and, you know, we've been playing a while, so we might be getting a little bit sloppy. Oh, right, we throw knives out our butts. So just need to remember that, because we can still, you know, the nice thing about this is you can take advantage of it. Because now you basically have a back attack if you're running away from an enemy or facing away. So you can dodge and attack at the same time, and that's a very useful technique if you can get it down and if you have the mana to use it. With a mage, it can be particularly stunning, although you have to get used to the fact that you can't cast forward, and that can be a problem. Whereas with the Paladin, you can actually, you know, use your sword more effectively, and that much is nice. Not much in here, though. And thankfully, since we're not playing as a lich, we don't have to spend time grinding up our HP. I tell you, I love the lich, but it just takes so much time to pay off, and you can die so quickly once you actually go down to the hard areas. So it's like, I like the lich, but I can see why people say it's the worst class in the game. And that's unfortunately hard to deny. I don't know why I ate that meat. I didn't need it. And now we're in the land of the Maya. Our damage is high. Our armor is good. Our sword is good. Certainly. I've got a good feeling about this. Herodotus, your days are numbered. And yes, we're giant. You can just immediately go die, sir. We've got a jukebox down here. Not gonna touch it since we haven't conquered the Land of Darkness yet, and I'm gonna give the music of the Land of Darkness its due that it deserves. Mr. Bones and Zomboner together forever in their permanent death. And we got ourselves a Retribution Cape. That's a new armor set. So yeah, even though I think we're going to have to go into New Game Plus to get the final sets of armor, I could be wrong on that, by the way. I could be very wrong on that. We're getting a lot of armor sets down here. A lot of really good armor sets, too. Like, holy crap. Get over here. So I can heal off of you. Oof. These dudes do hit hard. though. Really, really hard. But that's what the shield is for. I need to get better about actually using it, so I'm gonna make an effort. And we've found the boss door. Hello! Hello. And oh my god. Ermagerd. We actually have most of our HP. So after I clear out this room, I might just go right in there and fight Herodotus right away for round three. We've got equipment, we've got a good spell, we're pretty much ready to go. The only thing I would wish to get would be like a rune, but more money, or barring that, like a talisman, something from the shrines, because, you know. But I could just always get the Hedgehog's Curse, and that's never fun. I cannot believe that I just wasted that much HP doing that. You know, sometimes I can be really dumb. There's just no other words for it. That was really dumb. But hey, that's fine. That's fine. Because you see, even though we're nearly dead now, and that was a really bad idea, we can teleport back up into here, into the castle. And since we're in the castle, and we can teleport right back to the boss door whenever we want, we can look for the other transition rooms and for the boss door rooms that will be guaranteed meat, which isn't even to speak of the meat that we could get from the surrounding areas, which isn't even to speak of the HP we'll get back just by killing enemies with the balance rune. Point being, we can still salvage this. Also, I think this might be the episode we get the last rune on, not the previous episode, which I don't think we got all the runes on when I thought it would be the episode even before that. Go figure. And just killing these guys to make the room safe and to heal off of that, got ourselves some meat. Shouldn't necessarily be going into the Maya, but just poking the head into the rooms for the easier enemies. Well, that was an easy enough enemy to deal with. Okay. See? I know I screwed up badly. I got sloppy and I made a mistake that I shouldn't have made, but it will be easy enough to rectify. Rectify, not erectify. Now that's what I call a Freudian slip. And we've got most of our stuff back now. But why is this room saying I already... Huh. I can't believe I actually forgot to open a treasure chest. That's silly. And... Okay. And now I think we're pretty much ready to go and teleport back and... You know, we could also just go look for Alexander's door and risk taking more damage, but... It's all about calculated risks, man. And as we saw in the fight with Herodotus with our lich... Not our lich, but our assassin... What happened in that fight? Yeah, Herodotus' main technique isn't to do big hits that do a lot of damage, it's to hit you more times than you can account for and just do a lot of damage really fast. So it actually does matter keeping yourself kind of topped off, it really does help against him. Defeat all the enemies, easy peasy. Citrus squeezy. Okay, I'm done saying that now. I'm gonna get that out of my vocabulary. While we throw knives out our back to take care of these guys nice and easily. And I think that is the very last rune in the game. Which means magic chests will now give us different rewards. This is another room that's like take no damage, but we can do this easily if we just use our shield. See? Yep, now we're just getting stat increases and stuff like that, so we got all the runes. Which means it is pretty much time, I think, to go and take on that boss. And to also cap ourselves off with a fountain. Drink some fountain water, Have a good time. At this point, it's faster, I think. It would just be faster to find Alexander's door. And there's a warg. There's just a warg down there. I'm not even going to bother, because he's going to hit me. He's just going to hit me. Shrine? Sharon's Obel. Not complaining. Is this the first life I think we're on? You're probably also noticing now that the lives are lasting a lot longer now if they're not a class that dies really quickly. Just because, you know, again, it's just natural to spend more time in these slightly more forgiving areas. Even though, you know, you can still get careless and just take a lot of damage. I've never seen that room before. It is pretty tricky though. It is challenging in its own way. So where haven't we explored yet? We haven't explored down into the right. You know, with this life, I could easily do an all castle clear, but I'm not gonna do that unless I beat Herodotus and still have the rest of the life to do. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Bad pupper. And... Also, there are New Game Plus Pluses. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but in addition to New Game Plus, the game does change if you beat the game on New Game Plus and then do another round. It's less dramatically, but it's still dramatically. You'll probably get the idea when we actually do get to New Game Plus. Ouch. That hurt. Why is there a big ol' eyeball up there? Well, no matter. The visionary was not prepared, and now he is dead. I've already determined now we're not going to be doing like a New Game Plus Plus full playthrough, because that would just be ridiculous. And I just need to show you like, I just need to show you my complete file, which is like New Game Plus 6 or 5 or 6 or something. And that'll be enough for you to get the idea, because the dramatic changes stop at New Game Plus 2. And after that, it just kind of makes things stronger. But, you know, by then you'll have gotten the point. Where the hell is Alexander's boss door? Because I need to get out of here. Here it is. I'm sorry, Alexander, I didn't mean to yell at you. It's not your fault. And down we go. Full HP, I'm full of equipment. It's time for round 3 against Herodotus. I've got a good feeling about this. Which means I'm going to die. The Infinite, Herodotus, it is time for you to be slain. Whoa, 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 ouch. But again, Herodotus doesn't do that much damage. Count your blessings in this fight, but we're so big that we should be able to clear him away anytime he tries to come directly for us. Never forget about the blobbies. When you're focusing on these dudes, just never forget that these guys can always be in the wings. So while the main priority, I would say, is to just keep the enemies clear, you know. Is to just, like, keep the enemies clear. Herodotus is always going to be a threat in this fight. Even when he's just the little blobbies, they can jump incredibly far. And, you know, I mean, I've done a good job clearing out this area, but now there's, like, a ton of little blobbies down below, and I don't have the HP to take another hit, really. So what do you do in this situation, you might ask? Well, the answer is, we're probably going to die. Because we've taken care of all the spellcasters, but now there's like a million little blobbies just after our blood. And we got them. Herodotus is deceptively hard. Like, he seems easy at first, but once he gets down to a lot of little blobbies, it gets hard, especially since if you don't have periphery artery disease that affects your feet, you can't stay on the bottom, which means the game forces you to take an aerial battle, and you are not built to stay and attack from above. Most of the classes aren't. So that was Herodotus round 3, but we still have a lot of time, so let's see if we can't stick it to him again. Now, we haven't played as Sir Hero II. We haven't played as the Spellsword in a little while. even though they are kind of weird. They're a little strange looking. But, okay. Let's do it. Let's be the Sir Hero II, the insane spell sword. I mean, he's called Sir Hero II. What did you really expect was going to happen? Increase our invulnerability time. That's a nice thing to get. And we haven't upgraded our health in a while, so it might be good to increase that. Oh, but we should also increase our downstrike up so it's better, even though I don't do it a ton. I don't use it a ton, I know. But it's still useful. Oh. What is that new cape? I think it's the Dragon Cape or the Retribution Cape. Yeah, Retribution Armor does exactly what it sounds like. It just deals a lot of damage back to the enemies. And here we have all of those available for you to look at. It's pretty, isn't it? Hello, Sharon. I've got your obol. Let me in. Thank you. Alright. And yes, we do have the flame barrier on our... whosamacallit? Our spell sword. So that's going to be interesting. Oh, I think the game just stuttered there. Yeah, this is definitely going to be the last episode for today. But let's take a more direct approach. Let's just get right on down in there. Not in there, not in the spike pit. You think you're so hilarious with your comedic timing game. Well, that was kind of funny, actually. You got to admit. But hey, since we're in here, we may as well take advantage of this room and get ourselves some kind of bonus. I don't know what we'll be getting, but we'll be getting something. As soon as we clear out the enemies over here as well. And our strength is increased. Always nice, always very pleasant. Yeah, the fairy chests definitely stay relevant, even after you've gotten all of the runes, and they're just an easy way to get a lot of money or to level up your stats, particularly in leveling up your stats, because eventually those max out. But I don't know if there's a hard max, like if eventually even the fairy chests stop giving you stat upgrades, or if you can just become some ungodly beast through long grinding. But it looks like we have found the Land of Darkness. Let's see if we can't find the other entrance in, because I want to get the meat and use that to heal up. Yes, here we are. Get ourselves some of that and some meat. And it's time to head down in search of Herodotus's... This is a dangerous room. So that's what a giant fireball looks like. It's pretty good. It doesn't last long, but it does a lot of damage. And that counts for a lot down here. Spikes down here, not good. Blobby, over here. Spikes. Oh, and that dude is fake. I had a feeling something was weird about him. Those fireballs aren't real, so that's frustrating. Maybe being insane wasn't the best idea in this fight. I wonder if a fake enemy can spawn inside the boss arenas, now that I'm thinking about it. In which case, it would be really bad to be insane, especially in Herodotus' fight. That would be the worst fight to be insane in. I mean, really. Also, it would be pretty bad in Alexander's fight if it was a fake Fury. Wouldn't be so bad if it was anything else, though. This challenging room, though, is tough, but could be worse. And that could have gone a lot worse than it did, but thankfully it didn't go too bad. And we got run over and died. Well, Sir Hero II, your time on this earth was not long, but that's fine, because quite frankly, this episode would have gotten long if you lasted a long time, so, you know. You still got Divine, you still killed a lot of dudes, so that counts for something. Let's re-roll our children, because I wasn't really feeling any of them. Ooh. Couple of giant... Ooh. These are good. It looks like we might have to go and be a spell sword again. Twice in a row, I know, but I do like being giant, and I do like these abilities that we have here, that we could possibly have here. Sir Kenny the Sixth, is it time for you to redeem the names of the Kennys? Is it time? Who knows? We'll just have to wait and see. For now, though, we're going to upgrade our health a little bit, and then our mana a little bit. Look at those giant sword. Did I get any new blueprints? I forget. No, not really. But we will have to be upgrading our limbs soon enough. Let's just look at the magic runes that she has, just so we know that we've looked at all of them, and so that they're taken care of. There. They are all seen. Please let me in, Sharon. I'm ready to go die. Alright, this spell sword, this Kenny is gonna make up for the other Kennys, who did not have quite so much luck down there. Also, giant blade wall, that's gonna be useful against Herodotus, definitely. Assuming we can get there. We just need to, you know, we need to be fast but not rush. When you're ready to fight the boss, that's really the big thing. If you're not using the Architect anyway, which is, I've already spoken out against using the Architect, and I haven't used them yet, so I'm not going to start using them now. Okay. Why am I going up? It seems like even when I try to be focused, it's just, it's in my nature to go off and be distracted. Maybe I have a little bit of ADHD. Maybe not, though. Okay. Doesn't look like there's much in here. Or in here, for that matter. I do like being big and fast, though. This is a good combination to have. We're just zooming and zipping by everything, more or less. I don't know why there's water in this one room sometimes. I know it's just visual, but it's kind of weird to see the one room with water. Just ever, because water's never an element in this game that you ever have to deal with. So I don't know. It's just kind of strange, but it makes sense. I'm not bashing it. It's just a little weird. Why am I so fixated on this all of a sudden? To be honest, I don't know. I just don't know. Wow, that got a little real. But okay, okay, spike ball, okay. Got ourselves a little healing fountain. We don't need it right now, so I'm just gonna... Oh, this is good. Because now we know where that healing fountain is, we can just warp back here if we've taken damage and then heal up before we go on to fight the boss. So, wow, there's a lot of things clustered in here. We've got the Land of Darkness, we've got the forest right over there, and I assume this also technically goes into the Land of Darkness. Yep, it does. Oh, we've already taken a little bit of damage. Well, that's a little frustrating, but no worries, because there's some meat right there for us. We're so big, yet again. And that just goes right back into the forest, so this is pretty much our only entry point for the dungeon itself. Okay, heading back into the dungeon, heading back down. We've got a good entry point, so we don't need to wander around too much. Whoa, 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 it's Botus again. Well, this is what this move was made for. Well, unfortunately, it doesn't block projectiles. It is super handy against his charging move. Keeps him at bay long enough for us to kill him, and to get a reward worthy of the dungeons, we get the Sage Cape. It's a little outdated, but maybe that just, maybe it's just because the Sage equipment is kind of an optional set. The bottom row of equipment, aside from the very last set of armor, seems more gimmicky than the other sets of armor. Like, they're less stat-based and more, like, effect-based. Like, we saw that with the Vampire set, which was in the bottom left, but otherwise was kind of really crappy for its stats. And yeah, I know that room had a fairy chest in it, but had a lot of enemies in it, too. And my focus right now is not on fairy chests, but on the boss. We did so well in our first fight against Herodotus, too, as... what's his name? I don't remember his name, but he was a spelunker, so that made it particularly impressive. And there was fire there that I didn't account for, because I'm an idiot. Okay. All taken care of. Thankfully, our hitbox isn't as big as it looks. Yeah, this is gonna be great. This sword, against Herodotus, it's just going to be very, very useful. God damn it. But we get back so much mana, it's like, we may as well be, we should be using most of our spells. Once again, I maintain that the Spell Sword, one of the best classes in the game, bar none. But this is a very dangerous room. Oh boy. Well, at least we were able to get rid of the one ball from the ball and chain, so let's see if we can't take advantage of this and just kind of use that to our advantage. Also, the small blobbies, very fast. Not pleasant. But we were able to take them out without really taking any damage, so you know. Happy about that. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And for our trouble, we got ourselves a little more money. Money is always appreciated. We are taking some unnecessary hits, though. And all for a jukebox. Now I'm embarrassed. See, I really want to make this life count because this character really has what it takes to take on Herodotus. He's got a good spell. I frig took a hit that, oh, that was not good. He has a lot of good things going for him, so hopefully I can get back out of here just long enough to heal ourselves up, because we still have that fountain we can take advantage of near the beginning. And it would be nice to just, you know, find some meat or something. Well, there's the magic. Oh, I thought I... Did I already eat the meat? Huh. Well, for now, we're going to have to just drink that water, and that's going to have to hold us over for now. It would be nice if something broke into food, but we're not that lucky. Sadly. Okay, there's a lot of zomboners down there. But this works out. Because you see, they can't get past me. They can't really do anything to get back. And the hypergonadism, great ability to have. Okay, the best thing to do here is to just kind of wait for an opening and then take advantage of it to just drop a giant blade on them. Especially, geez, there are a lot of these assholes. Look at how much they're clustered together, though. We were able to just refill our mana in, like, one fell swoop. Also, I should have changed my vault rune into something else since we have the cape. I should have bought something else to compensate for that, as I was planning to do, but I guess I forgot. And that's two down, or three. Whoop. And we took a hit from this one regardless. That sucks. Okay. We can just get these guys to, like, come over here and kind of get them against, behind us. And unfortunately, he pressed up against us, and that's a shame. That's a shame. Well, we still made a lot of progress down there, but let me check the... All right, I'm going to do one more. Just one more life this episode. It's hard to stop. It's really hard to stop, and I don't like any of these characters, so I'm going to reset, and that's a giant endomorphic spelunker. Isn't that just wonderful? But this Hokage has pad. If we can get into the fight with... what's his name? That would be great. First things first, we're going to replace our vault rune. Which one has the vault rune? So we're going to replace that with the vampire rune so that we can get some stuff back. Okay. Because we still have two abilities besides that. So what kind of piece of new armor did we get? We got the new cape here, the Sage Cape. Gets you a lot of money, but it's very heavy. And a little too heavy for our taste. Now can we, is there any other thing available, or do we have to go on to the limbs right away? Okay, so we can just jump right ahead to the dragon limbs, which are black and nice. Very nice. They give us a lot of extra magic, which I'm grateful for. And they don't clash too badly with this armor. They still clash a little bit, but that's just something you gotta deal with. Sacrifices must be made. Okay. Herodotus, your time is nigh. And I mean it this time. Don't make fun of me. Please. I miss being huge. I love being huge. It's so fun, and I just miss it. Even though this character is still pretty big in their own right. Ouch. And we're getting 3 HP back per kill, so that's not bad at all. Oh yeah, and I forgot already that I chose this character because they have pad. They do have the foot disease that makes it so they get no foot pulse. Eek. What a strangely specific condition to have. Well, I guess there's all kinds of things out there in the world. And really, they could have done a lot more for this game if they wanted to. But that would have taken a lot more time, and I'm glad for the ones that they just put in here. Treasure at the end of this hallway, I'm not going to worry about it. It's easy room, but I've got other priorities right now. Like Herodotus. Herodotus is going to be annihilated. I say, as I travel through the upper areas of the castle. Not smart. Not smart at all. But hey, it's our favorite place, Kidder's boss door. But from here, where should we go? It looks like their best bet is to head back to the start of the dungeon and then just head back over to the east. And dumb hit, bad, sloppy performance. It's fine, everything will be fine. For our trouble, we're just gonna kill that dude, lose the opportunity for meat, but get meat from over there, outspeed the attack of that dude. Look at all these enemies, this is a very enemy-heavy area, or very enemy-heavy castle this time around. Now let's head down here. A defeat all enemies room. That would be easy enough, but we've got a priority now that the episode has gotten kind of long, so we're gonna head on down. Maybe you love more Mr. Devious, but, or maybe you hate more Mr. Devious, and I gotta, another jukebox. I gotta make these episodes not too long, because for my own sanity as well, because I still have to edit these things, and if they're long, I sit through most of them. Almost all of my episodes in the editor, just to make sure that nothing went wrong and that I get every little thing that I need to edit or put a message in. And I know I'd probably have an easier time if I marked it down as I went along or something, but that would be really hard to do in a time-efficient manner. Unless, like, I just made a little scribble at a time slot and just, you know, so I would know that I would have to go back to that time and do something there. But no. Oh boy, this is a dangerous room. It's just a silly room, actually. It's just really big, but he needed to die. He was just asking for it. But the game is making us work to get over to the underground, and I'm not too surprised by that. And what do we get for all of our trouble? But we finally found our way back down into the land of darkness. Nice try. But you will not be tricking me this time. For you see, I have not been juked. But I will be eating this meat just to heal up real quick. Because I did take some hits, but not as many hits as I was worried about. Yeah, Hokage's just doing some really good damage down here. Whereas most characters would have to do about like 4 hits to kill the enemies down here, Hokage's reliably killing them in about 2. And that's really great. Unfortunately, we are taking hits. And we don't have the most HP in the world, so you know. Need to be careful. More careful than I've been being. Oh, that's a lot of dudes. How do you even approach that down there? Well, we don't actually have the ability to complement it because, unfortunately for us, the blue bite down there will basically just jump right up and hit us immediately. So that path is out of the question. It's just, it's too dangerous. Too dangerous. And what do we have in here? The answer is nothing. What a strangely small-roomed dungeon area. I'm grateful for it, but... huh. I'm kind of curious why, for the prince's entries, he didn't really have much to say about the dungeons. Like, he had maybe two entries about it before he beat it. But maybe it's just because they wanted to keep this area a little more mysterious than the others, or maybe it's because they just couldn't think of anything to write for this area as much as they could have written for the others, because by then, through the other areas, they've already talked about most of the mechanics of the game, which were pretty much the purpose of the diary entries. Calypso's compass. Well, then I guess we need to go take care of this now. Is it, like, outside of here? First things first, I'm gonna find the boss door, because that is important. Because once we find the boss door and we can easily teleport to it, my biggest concern will be addressed. No, we got these guys, though. And unfortunately for them, we do too much damage against them for them to reasonably be a threat against us. Unfortunately, we did walk right into him. But thankfully, at the end of the day, we managed to get a piece of armor off of their dead corpse. And thankfully, we were able to find the boss door for Herodotus. And it'll be our last attempt against him today, but we're not going to be doing the fight against him just yet, because I want to find where Calypso's compass takes us. So first things first, I'm going to teleport over here and see where exactly that puts us in relation to the treasure. And just as I thought, it's a little bit higher up. Looks like it's a lot higher up, actually. But that's fine. It's treasure. It's treasure ahoy. And I don't want to ignore treasure. The call of treasure is just way too strong, and we are already clearing out most of this area because, I mean, look at it. Look at how much ground we're covering, and also how much we're going to get to heal by killing the enemies in here, too. But it looks like we can't quite get up there easily enough. I should have teleported up to Kidder's boss door, come to think of it now. Oh well. We'll just have to go back this way. And then go back over here. Thankfully. It doesn't look like it's that much further, but it is probably going to be up in the Maya. Which, you know, we could still reasonably die up there. And no joke about that. That's a very real threat. Maya is still dangerous, if not nearly as much as it used to be. Well, we got chicken out of that thing, out of the barrel, so that much is nice. Okay. Mimics die in one hit, so they're a non-issue. Most of the enemies are dying in one hit, so most of the enemies are going to be a non-issue. Even this mimic room was just kind of an afterthought, wasn't really a threat to us in any real substantial way. And as the compass begins to turn, we are getting a better bearing of where we need to go to get our treasure. No! Unfortunately, these guys still do some significant damage to us, which, in part, is because I haven't been leveling up my armor and my HP as much as I should have been, I'm pretty sure. But hey, we beat the boss, or the mini-boss, and we got ourselves more sage armor. I'm not sure if, like, a certain set of armor are relegated to certain tasks, like if you need to beat mini-bosses to get the sage armor or something like that, and they're otherwise you can't find them in the castle, or if it's just totally random based on the level of the chest. I have no idea. That might be something that would be fun to get the answer on, though. For now, though, it's time for destruction. And healing. We're pretty close to whatever this treasure is, or wherever it is, so that much is good. It's gonna be right up in here, maybe? Maybe? And we were getting more HP back, thankfully. It's not here. It's gonna be up in this room. Would you please just die, sir? Yeah, it's definitely in here. Right in here. Thank you for the armor. And thank you for the sage helmet. Getting a lot of equipment. Whoa. Now they tremble a little bit and they shake when they're about to pounce, but even despite that, you know, you gotta react within like a fraction of a second to get a good hit off on them. And when they're coming from below, there's not nearly as much as you can do. You can try to down thrust, but let me tell you, this game, down thrusting is not your character's strong suit. You can pogo pretty, if you get a good handle on the pogoing, you can do a lot of damage, but it's still tough. And Hyperion's Ring, this could be really useful in the fight. Assuming we get back there. We better get back there. I would be really mad if we didn't. Because we've already cleared out the most dangerous area, more or less. We don't really need to deal with the Land of Darkness any more than we already have. Okay, though. Oh yeah, I forgot that those guys switch up their patterns. So that's what makes them a difficult tier 3 enemy. That's their main challenge? That's a lot of dudes. Okay. Yeah, I know, I'm just kinda fiddling around in here. But, you know, I can make this work. I still want treasure. Treasure is still important, and we are looking for Alexander's boss, not Alexander's, but Ponce de Leon's boss door, because that's the way that I want to just teleport back to Herodotus, and by my calculations, we should be very close to it. And by calculations, I just mean we're almost out of rooms to explore. This room is tons of stuff. We got rid of one threat. Oh boy. And fortunately, we have been taking damage, not nearly as much as we could be taking, so that much is grateful, and we've found Ponce de Leon's boss door. So, I mean, we might as well head down in that room and get that treasure chest, heal up off a couple of hits, you know. See, we even got meat, so this was a good idea. And we took a hit like that, but nobody saw that. Nobody saw that. You can't prove it. What is video evidence? It's nothing. That's not admissible in a court of law. All right, though. Hold on to your butts, because it's time for round 4 against Herodotus. Yep, time for round 4. This time, though, we have a good advantage. We can stay down on the floor. Okay, Herodotus, are you gonna try and get down? And we've got the mage up here somewhere. Not a big threat, though. Okay. See, as you can see here, because we don't need to sprint around all hectically on the ground floor, we can actually get ourselves into the corner and take advantage of that, because the enemies can't really close in on us very effectively from down there. However, we are starting to take a lot of hits from the Gravizors, or whatever you want to call them. So we're going to do what we can to kill them. Also, as you can see here, we are getting back a lot of HP by killing the small ones, so that's good. Unfortunately, we are taking damage yet, but it looks like we've killed most of them. Herodotus, I think your days are numbered. I think at the end of it all, your time is over. And the deed is done. My friends, we have slain the last boss in the castle. That was supposed to be cool, but it wasn't. Let's open the chest and get our prize. We have slain Herodotus. In addition to Ponce de Leon, in addition to Alexander, in addition to Kidder. We've killed them all, and the boss door is open. So, teleporting, we're not going to teleport over there though, because we could go over to the main gate, But we're not going to do that because this episode's gotten long and I want to spend most of the rest of this life just kind of gathering money and just taking care of that so that we'll have a really good nest egg with which to take advantage of in preparation for our going through that door. Because that's going to be a big deal. It's going to be a very big deal when we go through there, and I want to be ready. I mean, don't get me wrong, I've already kind of come up with a plan for what's going to happen when we go through that door, but I'll talk about it in the next episode. I don't want to give away my plan entirely just yet, because somebody else might say that it was their plan. People might forget where my plan came from and say that they took credit for it. Imperial Helm, getting more armor? So, yeah, now that we have cleared out this, we've finished up the dungeon. 5 episodes, not bad considering the Maya took 8. And putting that all together, you know, pretty proud. Pretty proud. I think we've done pretty well in terms of time and just effort it's taken to take care of everything. Guard boxes are, though, always a pain. And can we kill this thing from above? Yes, we can. Blue bite. You know, it's funny, but there is a chance that I might just be able to clear out the castle. And then at that point, I don't know what I would do. I might have to separate the video if that happens, but don't get too expectant of that happening because I have very low HP and it just takes one bad hit for it all to end. Also, we weren't giant, but we were an endomorph, so we are technically slightly bigger, you know? Oof, that hurt. And we almost died there, but not quite yet. And it looks like we're still alive. We are still living. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. And we're finally dead. The tier 3 ninja... Oh, we're not dead because we still had Death Defy. I forgot about that. This life. What is this life? Let me tell you. It is an amazing life. What's your name? Sir Hershey the Second? Hershey? Your name's Hershey? That's fantastic. Well, Sir Hershey, you've got a great future ahead of you. By which I mean you're still probably going to die because I do not think you're going to be taking out the end game by yourself. I just, you know, I got a feeling, just a feeling that you're not going to be living that long. Maybe I'm wrong, though. I've done a lot of the castle. I've done a lot of the castle, and I've almost finished up the dungeon, too, for that matter. Like, what was down here again? Oh, yeah. A lot of nonsense. And we've got a take no damage fairy chest. We've got another long room in here. Don't know what this room's deal is. Just a couple of stronger enemies. No jumping fairy chest? Easy. Easy. Damn it, I jumped. I don't know why I jumped. Because I make bad decisions, that's why. So let's dash on out of here. Can we get down there without taking damage? Well, we can do this. Take care of some of the enemies below. Oh. And we're making a good job clearing out most of the enemies down here. Or we could just miss entirely. Oh, and we took damage, so we can't get the treasure anyway, but we can get the money and kill you and you. See, now I'm doing dangerous things because I kind of want to die to end this episode, so... I mean, I'm not going to say I killed myself there, but we are dead. Sir Hershey the Second has been slain by a plantite. But I'm okay with that because as you can see on the 4th row down, 4 or 5 rows, you can see Herodotus' bloopiness right there. But otherwise, though, we've made quite a bit of progress. We've beaten all 4 main bosses. And that means, then the next episode, we're going through that gate. If you want to see what's on the other side, then I just hope to see somebody in the next one. Buh-bye!